During the 13th century, there was a dangerous heresy that was prevailing in the southern part of France. It was called the Albigensian heresy. According to this heresy, there were two principles that were governing the entire universe. One, the good principle, and the other, the evil principle. According to this heresy, the good principle was the creator of spiritual world, whereas the evil principle was the creator of material things. According to them, the matter was evil, marriage was evil, procreation was evil, Jesus Christ was not truly human, and as a result, Mary was not his mother. Saint Dominic was greatly troubled because so many people left their true faith and started following the Albigensian heresy. And so he started preaching against the Albigensian heresy. Initially, he was very much discouraged because he was unsuccessful. And in the year 1208, he was sitting in a church at Pruyl and pouring out his sorrows to Our Blessed Mother. And Our Blessed Mother appeared to him in a vision, gave him the Holy Rosary and said to him, "One day, through the Holy Rosary and the scapular, I will save the whole world." From then on, the Holy Rosary became the comfort and consolation of Saint Dominic. My dear friends, nearly 700 years later, on May 13, 1917, Our Blessed Mother again appeared at Fatima to three shepherd children. All of a sudden, there was lightning and thundering. The frightened children started going back to their houses. Our Blessed Mother appeared to them and spoke to them very gently. She asked them, "Are you willing to offer yourself to God? Are you willing to accept sufferings from God as an act of reparation for the sinful world?" They said, "We are willing." Again, she asked them, "Are you willing to offer your supplication for the conversion of sinners?" And they said, "We are willing." And Our Blessed Mother said, "From now on, you will suffer much, but the grace of God will be your comfort and consolation." And the three children, after that, started reciting the Holy Rosary. And through the recitation of the Holy Rosary, they experienced the comfort and consolation of Our Blessed Mother. My dear friends, as human beings, we want to feel the comfort and consolation of someone whenever we are in pain and suffering. When a child is fallen on the ground, or when its finger is cut, or when its finger is burnt, immediately it runs to its mother because it knows its mother can give true and genuine comfort and consolation. We too, in our life, whenever we are in suffering and pain, want to experience the comfort and consolation of Our Blessed Mother. And the best way to experience the comfort and consolation of Our Blessed Mother is through the recitation of the Holy Rosary. Our Blessed Mother said to Lucia at Fatima, "There is no problem, no matter how difficult it is, that cannot be resolved through the recitation of the Holy Rosary." My dear friends, the Mother Church recommends each and every one of us to recite this Holy Rosary as a community of prayer and as a family prayer. My dear friends, the Church highly recommends each and every one of us to recite this Holy Rosary as a community and as a family. If you want, we can recite it individually also. I would like to bring before you a couple of reasons as to why we need to recite this rosary as a community and as a family. Saint Montfort says, if anyone recites the Holy Rosary alone, he gets the merits of one rosary. On the other hand, if he joins another 30 in the recitation of the Holy Rosary, he would receive the merits of the 30 rosary. The second reason we find in the Gospel of St. Matthew chapter 18 verses 19 to 20. There our Blessed Lord says, if two of you on earth agree on anything you ask, my Heavenly Father will give it to you. Further he says, for where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there in your midst. So my dear friends, in order to receive the merits in a double measure, and in order to experience God's presence in a community and also in a family, we recite this Holy Rosary as a community and as a family. So my dear friends, as we are entering into the month of the Holy Rosary, and also as we are under quarantine, we have a lot of time. Let us make use of this time in order to increase our devotion to the recitation of the Holy Rosary. Through the recitation of the Holy Rosary in community and also in the families, let us experience the comfort and consolation of our Blessed Mother. May our Blessed Mother, the Comforter of the afflicted, intercede for each one of us. May God bless you all.